Donald Trump's budget cuts $57 billion from programs that help fight poverty and build economic security are leaving Americans in the dark. And for people of color, it's pitch dark. During a CBC panel on poverty, children's advocate Marian Wright Edelman, founder of the Children's Defense Fund, was among several panelists weighing in, and she did not hold back.
The black child, all of these years after the Civil Rights Movement and after all the sacrifice of so many, is still the poorest child in America. Why are we permitting it? You know, it's just that we know what to do to eliminate child poverty. In 1994, we asked Bob Solow, who was a Nobel laureate economist at MIT, and who got the Presidential Medal of Freedom in recent years, to look at, the cost of child poverty and wasting America's future, and he laid out very clearly. But this is not an act of God. This is something these are deliberate policies. Mm-hmm. And let me just say, it's the lack of deliberate voice by us. And you've got to begin in the black community, in the coal community, to stand up and say, we're going to end it. You got a bad new bill. They just are not going to give up on taking away the health care of our children from Medicaid and ACA and CHIP. And they're back at it again with Lindsey Graham and Bill Cassidy. And we've now got 95% of all children covered by CHIP and Medicaid and other private insurance. They're trying to tear it all down. I hope that every one of you right now will make a commitment to calling up these folks right this afternoon and say, don't go there. And if they do try to go there, you just make sure that you get a mission to say, I'm going to make sure you don't come back to Congress. You've got to start speaking up for your children.
And I'm just going to quote a few statistics. According to new poverty numbers from the U.S. Census Bureau, while the number of Americans living in poverty decreased by more than 2.5 million, there are still 40 million Americans living in poverty. And of the 40 million who are still locked in poverty, 9 million are African Americans. So poverty rates are still disproportionately affecting the African American community.
The median wealth for African Americans is $1,700. The median wealth for Latinos is $2,000. And median means 50% have less, 50% have more, right? So right in the middle. Median wealth for whites is $117,000, right? So, you know, wealth is the tool that we use to get us through rough economic times. It's also the tool that we use to help us take advantage of economic opportunity. Do we want to start a business? Do we want to buy a home? Do we want to send our kids to college? You know, but with $1,700, that's not much to take advantage of any opportunity. That doesn't really help you much with a small car accident, right?
So government assistance lifted 43 million people above the poverty line in 2014. That includes 7.7 million African Americans. TANF lifted 1 million people out of poverty in 2014, including 300,000 African Americans. SNAP lifted 8.8 million people out of poverty in 2014, and about 2.2 million African Americans. Housing subsidies lifted about 4 million people out of poverty in 2014, and that included 1.5 African Americans. The refundable tax credits, including the EITC, lifted about 10.7 million people out of poverty, and that included 2.3 million African Americans. So we know that history of slavery, institutionalized racism, discrimination, we're not going to be surprised that African Americans are disproportionately poor and disproportionately low income. But the safety net does work, and the safety net is critical to African Americans in poverty.
Days on TV One.
I will never lie to you.
Oh my God.
Roland Martin.
He doesn't want to talk to us. He wants to ignore us.
Uncensored.
Hell no! That ain't no cut it, boo.
Unapologetic.
No, that is fundamentally false. You are wrong.
Unfiltered.
He wants an America where we all look alike. He ain't talking about black people.
Unrelenting.
You better go work out, because you got a fight on your hands.
News One Now with Roland Martin. Weekdays at 7 a.m. on TV One.